Hello everyone, welcome back to Ganesha Academy. Today we are going to learn a fantastic poem, New Year Resolution by Elizabeth Swell. This is a short, sweet poem which tells us about the promise of the poetess made by her at the arrival of New Year. Generally, the New Year arrival is a time of merrymaking, dancing, drinking, etc. It is also a time of self-examination and for the preparation of the next year in a better way. In this poem, the poetess is determined to celebrate the New Year away from the traditional manners. Now the poem is, I will drain long draught of quiet as purgation, remember twice daily who I am. Will lie o' nights in the bonny arms of reality and be comforted. Now, difficult words in this poem. Long draughts of quiet means keep quiet or silence. Purgation means purification or cleansing. Bonny arms means hard reality of life. Now, explanation. First stanza, I will drain long draught of quiet as purgation. In these lines, the poetess expressed that she has decided to welcome New Year with a better understanding of life. She vows to do three things in the New Year. She will try to become a pure person. She will purify her soul from all past follies and foibles. She will sit silently for a long time and take stock of her past life. She has come to know that silence is the only method to purify the soul. She wants to clean her mind, heart, and soul in the depth of silence. She believes that meditation in silence will help her in knowing all her past shortcomings. Thus, she will get rid of all of them easily and become a person with a pure soul after self-assessment. Now, second stanza, remember twice daily who I am. This is the second stanza of the poem. In this stanza, the poetess describes her second resolution that she will try to know her true identity and true object of her life. She will try to know who she is, why has been sent to this world, what are her duties and responsibilities, what has she done and what left undone. In fact, she will try to realize her duties toward God, toward herself and toward humanity. After knowing the true object of her life, she will remember it twice a day before going to sleep. She will never forget her task and duties in her future life. Third stanza, will lie all night in the bony arms of reality and be comforted. These are the concluding lines of the poem. Here the poetess says she will accept reality while sleeping at night. She will consider the bitter reality of life during the new year. She will make some promise and pledge. She will sleep on thin, less flashy arms of reality. Accepting reality and facts is always a difficult thing, but she will accept it bravely. She will feel relieved and satisfied when she comes to know that she has spent her life for the benefit of others. The image of bony arms is a hard reality. Even then, she will get delight and feel comforted when she has fulfilled her promise and resolutions she has made on the start of the new year. Now, summary of the poem. New Year is traditionally a time of making new resolutions. Her first resolution is that she would remain silent most of the time. She would think for long hours and purifies herself for the future. Her second resolution is that she would ask herself twice a day, who is she? What are her responsibilities? Her third resolution is to face the reality of life. Even though reality is bitter and based on bony arms, but she would feel comfortable in the company of reality. It is a criticism of those people who live their lives without aims. They do not make decisions for the future. They do not want to face the reality of this world. They do not make aims and decisions for the future life. Through the resolutions, the poetess wants to convey the moral message of the poem. She says that human beings should live their lives according to the set pattern. They must analyze their past shortcomings. After taking stock of all the past misdeeds, the people should make plans for the future. Now, theme of the poem. The poetess throws light on the blessing of self-examination. This dignifies and purifies one's soul. She wants to take stock of her past misdeeds and wrongs in a rational manner. Her aim is to lead a better life at the start of New Year. Long thought of quiet also suggests that she will keep quiet most of time. This will be best means for the purification and it will help her in leading beneficial and successful life. She says she will talk less and hear more and change her life into betterment. She will remember herself twice daily. She should recognize herself, which will help her in recognizing God and leading life for the benefit of others. Accepting reality and facts is always a difficult thing, but she will accept it bravely. Now, important questions and answers. First one, what New Year resolution does Elizabeth Swell make in her poem, New Year Resolution? Answer to this question is, the poetess does not welcome the new year in a traditional manner. She has a firm belief that life must be spent consciously and with a sense of responsibility. She resolved that she will analyze her own mind and soul in order to find out her past shortcomings. Firstly, the poetess resolved that she will remain silent. She will think over her past wrongs. The long hours of silence will help her in cleaning her inner self. She wants to commence the new year in a better and realistic manner. She has no intention to repeat the mistake she did last year. She is determined to improve herself every day. Secondly, the poetess resolved that she will think about her identity. She will think twice a day who she really is. What are her responsibilities in this world? Thirdly, the poetess says that she will decide to face the reality of her life. She will think over the shortcomings and blunders with a cool mind. She decides to feel ashamed for her mistake and work done before. She will never desire to remain in a dream world. She will face the bitter reality of life with a stout heart. In this way, she will welcome the new year with new zeal and zest. Second question, discuss the literary qualities of the poem New Year Resolution. Answer to this question is, the poem is a criticism of those people who live their lives without aims. They do not make plans for the future. The poem is a satire on the lazy people. They do not want to face the reality of this world. The poet expressed her views that are based on the resolution of the poetess. Through her resolution and decision, the poetess wants to convey the moral message of the poem. She says that human beings should live their lives according to the set rules. They must analyze their past and make good plans for a better future. The language of the poem is very simple and impressive. The word purgation is a medical term. It means cleaning a wound from a germ, but poetess has used this term for cleaning the human shortcomings, which are also like germs. This poem is based on realistic subject matter. According to the poetess, life must be spent consciously and with a sense of discipline. In this poem, reality has been personified with a solace companion. The poetess sleeps in the company of reality. The poem is serious with a realistic theme. Next question, what is the moral and central idea of the poem? Answer to this question is, New Year Resolution is a thought-provoking poem. In this poem, the poetess gives us an important message. She believes that life is a temporary, but we should spend life doing productive works. She says that we must take stock of our past life. We must analyze our weakness at the beginning of the new year. Self-examination will help us to correct ourselves. The poem criticizes that people who are lazy and have no aims or goals in their lives. They are not decisive by nature. They do not make decisions for the future. They do not want to face the reality of this world. They do not make aims and resolutions in their lives. This poem presents a philosophical lesson. The poetess urges us to examine our past deeds. It advises us to be always ready to correct ourselves. We must face the bitter things in a sincere manner. We must work for the betterment of our country and fellow beings. We must analyze our deeds twice in a day. We must accept the harsh reality of life with a smiling face. We should not be discouraged after facing difficult situations in our life. We must welcome the new year with a brave heart. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe the channel Nana Share Academy.